Porque podemos hacer algo. Cinema Planeta 2016.
First of all, it was completely forbidden to be there. Places like garbage dump are very, very dangerous. They are surrounded by fence. There is a security. There is a checkpoint at the entry. There are people walking around with walkie-talkies. It's an area where you have the heavy machinery working, where you have, where you have different dangers. Toxic waste being dumped, so the machines, the trucks, it's a lot of rotten stuff. The security don't want these things which are being thrown away to get back to the market, possibly. So for different reasons, this place is very tightly secured, and in Russia it's even called a military traverse. It's actually a military controlled area, so it is especially kind of no trespassing. A place very, very tightly isolated and secured. And you know, I have to tell you that some other people who I knew who tried to film at the garbage dump, one woman I met, her camera was smashed, her nose was broken, and it's actually a violent place because you are not welcome there. You are documenting something which no one wants you, not only officially you are not allowed to be there, but then there is a lot of other dangers involved. Like I say, it's actually a mafia-run place. People were paid by vodka, which was not even vodka. People were dying like flies. If somebody dies, of course, there is never police there, or never, like if a woman was raped or killed or stabbed or whatever, no one would ever call the police. No one would ever even oftentimes call ambulance. Those people are completely, they are void of any rights. They're completely separated from the world. And it's actually creating a situation when you have kind of country in the country. The normal law of the country do not apply. They don't apply because it's a place where, like I say, if the police comes, they protect the place from outsiders, not protect people inside.
Жили сначала нормально. Отец работал, мать работала. А потом мать перестала работать. Отец пил. Получилось.
Well, I think it was a natural relationship. Like, I liked her very much. I thought she's a very intelligent and funny and smart and nice girl. And I think she liked me very much. She always, when I would be coming to the garbage dump, she would always come around and she was very shy. She never wanted to really be much on the camera. She never wanted to speak. When I asked her some questions, she would tell me, oh, ask someone else. She was a very difficult character, ultimately, but of course I could not know when I started to do this film that ever something like this will happen in her life, that maybe at age 16 she will become pregnant, or that I will follow her until 24, that her life, in the contrary to everybody else, will change so dramatically. So there was many things which I couldn't foresee, and of course we still have a very, very deep relationship. I really like her. I worry about her. Even recently she asked me for some help, and then she felt very ashamed that she did ask, and I left my country. I was in Germany and I didn't have the internet for some days, and when I came back I found all these messages which clearly said that she really freaked out, that she thought maybe I rejected her because she asked me for help. And she was telling me, oh please forget about this, but just please do not reject me, just please don't take your friendship away. So I think I am important in her life, and it's over beyond any film, anything, you know. It's you spend time with people, you start to know them, you start to, of course she has her faults, especially after living in a place like this. She lives in a very tough society. Sometimes she has to be very tough. Sometimes, she has a certain emotional, I would say, atrophy, you know, like she doesn't have a certain reactions as other people would have. Sometimes I can see that she herself searches for herself, she's contradicting herself, because she just simply doesn't have a certain experience, she doesn't have a certain brought up, all what she has seen in her life, it was dying, it were dying people, a lot of alcohol addiction, alcohol abuse, substance abuse, a lot of violence, you know, people were basically dying like flies at the garbage dump. Every time you get attached to somebody, the person died. So of course it's, and I'm talking both about the children, about her friends, as well as adults which were surrounding her. Her father died at the garbage dump, he died of tuberculosis. Her mother's sister died at the garbage dump. She got poisoned with something what she ate or drank at the garbage dump. So it's basically, you know, the very, very tough and hard life. And like I say, she's maybe not free from some kind of imperfections in her life, but at the same time she has those really amazing qualities and a lot of poetry in herself. I don't know, she's very, for this situation she came out, she's like absolutely amazing. She's very honest, she can be very kind, she can be very poetic, she can speak in metaphors, you know, she can have a lot of, she's very punctual. She's more punctual than I am, so she has all these different qualities which you don't even expect from a person who grew up in this kind of conditions. You know, I asked her about it. I just asked her this question. After she already got out from the dump, I asked her, do you think that I had some kind of... I participated in, and she said, you were certainly a big part of it. Of course, maybe not the only one, because there was many different situations, but she told me you always were moralizing, you would always explain things to me, you would always come and show that there is another life, another, you know, type of existence, that garbage dump is not the whole world. And she said maybe the quality which I have, she was talking about herself, she said that I just listen, that I have this kind of, maybe I am unique in this terms, that if anybody offers me the smallest chance, I just take it. It's not really a film about the garbage dump, it's a film about somebody deciding to make a change in life, and it's in our power, you know. We see so many films, so many. I was just watching on the plane coming to Mexico. I was watching the film about Janis Joplin, a beautiful film. But she, as well as Amy, and as well as Kurt Cobain, as well as many other, they were offered so much, and basically it went wasted. You know, people were taking drugs, drinking, you know, being depressed, and you actually have everything and you don't really use it. And here you have someone who is completely, as a small child, taken to the garbage dump, completely cut off the society, is in this vicious cycle from which basically there is no way out, because once you go there, you are basically cursed. It becomes your destiny. It becomes impossible to reach out back. It becomes very, very difficult. Maybe not impossible, but almost impossible to get out, because the society rejects you. You have no tools. You have no means to go there back.
Ну-ка, мечту свою скажи, тебе сказать. Я бы хотел поменять вообще свою жизнь. Уехать за свою.